Welcome back to West Sound TV presents High School Football 2011. We are watching the Bainbridge Spartans take on the Eastside Catholic Crusaders up here at Bainbridge Island and at Spartan Stadium. At the end of two quarters of play, it is tied 10-10. Both teams having scored a field goal and a touchdown. Bainbridge received at the beginning of the first half, so Eastside Catholic will be receiving at the beginning of this half. We have out there for Bainbridge Chris Bell, one of the captains, Nicholas Moore, Sam Ori, and Logan Dietrich, all seniors, class of 2012 being honored tonight. At halftime, they honored the members of the band. That band is led by Lillian Garcia, members of the flag team, members of the cheerleading squad. All the seniors are being honored tonight here up at Bainbridge Island. Well, we are West Sound TV. I am Kitty Campagna on the microphone. And then on our camera, we have Spencer Anderson, who is also doing the live streaming tonight and running the computer to bring it to you live on the internet, as Doc says, via kitsapsun.com/GOTW. And this is just the beginning or the middle of an extremely long week of working. We streamed the volleyball game on Tuesday, which had South Kitsap at North Kitsap. Coming up this week, we have Squim at North Kitsap tomorrow evening at 7 p.m. at the Game of the Week site. On the 25th, Tuesday, Kingston at Olympic, but that can be found on kitsapsun.com/news/sports. And then on the 28th, it will be another extremely important battle as far as the Narrows League goes. Central Kitsap at South Kitsap. That could be for the last playoff spot. But now it's a kickoff by Connor Winship. Going deep. Looks like Chevy Walker with it. He's going to the outside looking for a seam. And instead he meets a Spartan. Oh, and it's a fumble! Spartans have picked it up. The symbol, we'll see what they're going to show us. Fans standing in front of me on purpose, and they're going to say it's Eastside Catholic. I am not sure why, but it looked like that ball came out before he hit the ground. But where we're at, we can't hear the whistle. So you start with controversy to begin this third quarter, tied 10-10. Little scoring recap. It all started out with a field goal by Bainbridge at 8-17. Touchdown from Reynolds to Springfield at 4:18 in the first quarter. And then a touchdown, Max Weisong bringing it in for Bainbridge. And here comes the quarterback. This is Reynolds. He's one of their strongest runners. Double threat, passes and runs. Has enough for a first down and brings it up to the 47-yard line. And the final score happened in the second quarter with 8:26 remaining to make it 10-10. And that was a Crusader field goal. First and 10 at the 46-yard line, their own 46. Reynolds back at quarterback. Walker comes right past, does take it. It's almost as if he got the hike. And he is across midfield and into Spartan territory. It is a brisk October 20th, a little bit warmer than our Bremerton game on last Friday, possibly because I'm actually in covered stands this time. But still very cool. Parents with blankets and coats and trying to keep warm with the excitement alone. 10-10 with 10:53 remaining in the third quarter. Walker coming across again. Reynolds with the ball. Looking out there, sees his receiver, and that is not going to be any good. It hit turf and just was not in the hands of Luke Latanzio. Third and six from the 50. This Crusader team so tough to defend as they have so many weapons out there, but the secondary has done a yeoman's work this evening. Chris Bell, one of them back there. Sam Callis. Reynolds kept it, and he is tripped up, but looks like, depending upon where they spot it, he might have that first down. Spots a little shorter than where he eventually ended up. It says fourth over there. They might be bringing in some... Nope, fourth and inches at the 44.
Just short of a first down. It's fourth and less than a yard.
Reynolds in the shotgun. He's going to take it up the middle. He's definitely got enough for the first down. He's down to the 40.
Reynolds keeps the ball just inside the 40-yard line. Down by Nick Moore.
Such a double threat out there. He can pass. He can run. But he can also be substituted out for the senior Luke Shepherd, which happened in the first half. Trey Reynolds, one of the captains of this Crusader football team, listed at 6 foot, 185. He's a junior. Walker in motion. And he finds a receiver out there. Looks like he's gotten enough for the first down and more. A couple yards past. On the other side of the field. That's Chevy Walker who ended up with it. He was the man in motion who came across. And that's going to be first down Crusaders. Putting them on the 29 of the Spartans. Once again, marching straight down this field. Bainbridge doing a nice job at the end of the half, bending and not breaking with the interception right before the end of the half. One back behind him, Walker. Walker's looking for a hole. They'd grabbed him once. He's still going, but I see a flag. See if that's going to be one more hold on this Eastside Catholic team. Several times they stalled the drive in the second quarter with holds. And it is a hold, the man in the white hat shows us. Going to move him backwards again. This is way back at about the 30 that flag is. We'll see if they spot it from there. And it does look like that's what they're going to do. So instead of what would have been almost first and goal, they are going in the backward motion. So they are now on the 40-yard line, first and 21. Bainbridge trying to blitz a few times. They had one coming around the side that time, but not successful. Or actually on the play prior to that. 16 moving around out there. Oh, he's looking for Walker. Oh, and he is sacked for a huge loss. That's Tatura with the sack. Tatura is a 6'4", 220-pound junior, and I believe Reynolds felt every pound on him. That's going to make it second and 30. Half of the county to go. Almost as far back as making it to Eastside Catholic. They're just all doing run down the middle. 18 with the reception. That is Hayden Meyer bringing it back into very doable third down territory. That's a 24-yard gain, which is going to make it third and six on the 25-yard line. And Eastside Catholic up to the line immediately. Look to the sideline to be sure whatever play it is. I see him signaling from the side. 18 he's looking at again, but this time he's going to get number three, Callens, brought down by Callis. First down. Now first down and goal. A couple of the chain gang get to take a break and put him down.
The 10-yard line of the Spartans.
And actually, it is a barely past the 10, so they can get a first down without a touchdown. Walker in motion. He's going to get that handoff. Oh, he turns back. He sees something, but there's going to be another hold, I think. Those Eastside people are going to be worn out. They have cheered for two touchdowns that have been called back. We'll see if this one is as well, or one touchdown. We'll see if this is. It's another hold. 7:45 remaining here in the third quarter. Used up a good 5 minutes almost. 4 minutes so far in this drive, going straight down the field. Not deterred by a first or second and 30. One more opportunity to prove they can do those big plays. What was first and almost goal, now is first and 21.
First down and 20 yards to go from the 21-yard line.
They're on the 21-yard line. Bainbridge setting their defense. Chris Bell yelling at his teammates. He's fun, easy to find in his yellow shoes. Walker's going to come straight across. Man in motion. He's going to be the man that he's looking for. But no, he's going to one farther down. And I could not see a number on who received that. They've moved it. Fair amount away from us now. And it is second and seven. Eastside continuing to get a lot of positive and getting back their yardage they're losing on penalties. Well, this time he finds his man from the backfield. It's Walker, and I think they can cheer. I don't see the indication. Right to the goal line. Third and, or it may be first down all over again. I don't know if he has quite enough for a first down. They've called timeout and are going to do a measurement. Just an opportunity to thank you for being with us this evening on our live streaming with the Kitsap Sun. And check out westsoundtv.org. Let's see what they've said. It is a first down. Oh, they are checking still. If I had my binoculars, maybe. And it is a first down, so goal to go from less than one. Awfully tough for the Spartans at this point. 6:50 remaining here in the third quarter. Eastside Catholic just keeps moving and moving.
There Eastside Catholic will have it. First and goal to go.
Looks as if it's right on the line this time. Walker has it, but he is denied. Bainbridge fans liking that as he loses a couple yards. Interesting alignment on that one.
Hunter Kane on the stop for the Spartans. Loss of 1 yard.
So that's a loss of about a yard. Second and two, or getting it over that goal line is the Crusader job. Number 40 goes through. Henry Jarvis, sophomore for the touchdown. So Jarvis with the 2 yard run will put the Crusaders in the lead at the moment, 16 to 10 with 6:10 remaining here in the third quarter. Danny Omiliak in for the extra point. He too is a senior. 6'3", 165, with a leg that hits it, and it's no good. Missing the kick, giving Bainbridge new life in some ways, but Bainbridge has plenty of time. The only team so far to have had the ball was Eastside Catholic. They used about 6 minutes to score that with pass and run and several penalties that took them backwards. Now Bainbridge will receive the kickoff. We are Westside Sound TV. I am Kitty Campagna on this mic. Spencer Anderson doing the live streaming and doing the camera as well. The score is 16 to 10 in favor of the East Catholic Crusaders. Bainbridge with their first opportunity to have the ball this half. Three men back waiting for the kickoff. One of those is Chris Bell, the quarterback. I see number 17 as well. That's Hayden Brown. And on the other side, Payman, or 16, I believe, Sam Callis. A lot of their defensive backs back there, basically. Eastside Catholic huddling up, preparing for the kickoff. We've seen one or two onsides tonight. We also know that the leg of this particular kicker can take it quite the distance. Omiliak does a bouncer on the hands of number 87. Really nice job. Looking for a lane. Might have one. He's pulled away from one tackler, but is met by another. That's Kyler Mikami. And I'm not sure. I think number two is the one who brought him down there at the end. Markel Sanders.
Barnes have it first and 10 from their own 48-yard line.
First and 10, 48-yard line. That is Joshua Fitch with the burst of energy. He's got 9 yards on that. Second and one. Bainbridge huddles up. Bell up behind center. Keeps the ball, still has it. He's going deep. Who's down there? Oh, so close. Oh, now we see a flag. That was number 27, Aaron Nordberg. There is a flag on the play. Number three, Matt Callens on the defense. We'll see if there's an interference or what's happening. They might be discussing whether or not it was a catchable pass. It was a little bit high, but looked like Nordberg could sky and might have been held down just a little bit there, so we'll see.
Personal foul
on the Eastside Catholic team. Now in high school, they don't indicate a number of who it was. Although, let me tell you, the coaches do film this and they will look at it. Now the personal foul will go from the line of scrimmage and not where it occurred. So they're going 15 forward. So it is a first down for Bainbridge at the 28. And I see another flag. We might have some problem at the bench that's going on over there. Chris Bell looking uncertain as to what this flag is. And I think that's unsporting conduct. Unsporting conduct against Eastside Catholic. So that one I think came against the bench. Not appreciating the first penalty or having argued the first penalty. Bainbridge is taking that once again, getting a ton of yards via the yellow flag. See if they can take advantage of this and go in for a lead. The score being 16 to 10 with 5:23 remaining in the third quarter.
With the combination of the penalties, the ball is now spotted at the Eastside Catholic 14-yard line.
Bainbridge has entered the red zone. They are at the 14-yard line, first and 10. Bell's just going to keep it. He got a good, solid, probably 7 yards. Good job of blocking on that side.
8 yards. The ball is marked at the 7-yard line of Eastside Catholic. We'll be second down. There's 2 yards to go.
Whistles again. Second and two for the Bainbridge Spartan on about the 7. Conversations between the referees once again. Oh, I believe we have a downed Eastside Catholic player, and so they've called a timeout to bring in the athletic trainer. Bainbridge men moving back from that. Never something you want to see. Some of the names that I think you're used to hearing for this Bainbridge squad, or maybe from the Eastside squad, you're not hearing tonight because of injuries. High school season, a long season. These guys do a great job with their conditioning and preparing for the season, but there's some things you just can't see happening. I am trying to read a number. I think it says 75. He runs off, which is a good sign. If it is 75, that was Christian Shigley. Bainbridge immediately with the ball. We got Weissong. Takes it to about the 1-foot line. But that should be another first down.
That's enough for a Spartan first down.
So first and goal for the Bainbridge Spartans with 4:44 in the third quarter. Less than a yard to go. Bainbridge comes up to the line. Bell behind the center. Two backs in the backfield. Bell's just going to take it forward, and we're going to watch those hands go up for a touchdown. Touchdown, Chris Bell, senior. That's going to tie up the score at 16-16. At 4:29 remaining in the third quarter. Chris Bell with a 1-yard run. And the Connor Winship in for the all-important extra point. Through the uprights, out to the Wells Fargo sign, out to the home of the Spartans. It is good. That puts them up 17-16. These two extremely even teams separated by an extra point at the moment. Bainbridge going to have to kick off and see if they can get their defense just a slight bit tougher. The Eastside Catholic has mainly been stopped by penalties and then not stopped. So they have had their way with this Bainbridge defense. But they are behind right now because the Bainbridge offense has done the exact same thing to the Crusader defense. The only thing that separates them is a goalpost that was in the way of an extra point. On camera tonight, I have Spencer Anderson. He's also our streaming director. I'm Kitty Campagna from West Sound TV. You're getting this. This is brought to you by the Kitsap Sun, who have been doing streaming for a couple years, and this year we have joined forces because we've been doing filming for quite a while. So if we combine, we hope to bring you a pretty good product. Tonight's a one voice operation, not a typical thing, but a Thursday night up at Bainbridge is a little bit more difficult at times. So, but what a lovely Thursday night. It's turned out reasonably warm. My legs are not shaking nearly as much as last week. And there's no rain. The mist has gone away. And it's one heck of a football game. Look at that kick by Winship, taking it deep. Jeffy Walker coming out with it. Scary Renner. He's got a path. Oh, what a block. He has to have gone out of bounds. It's Winship as one of them bringing him down. And that's in Bainbridge territory. Looks like they're calling him out at about the 41. And it is first down. Walker proving that he's quite the runner when he finds a seam. Reynolds back in as, or still in as quarterback. And Walker in the backfield. And he's going to keep it himself. They've read it correctly, and he's down! Number 58, one of them in there. And number 33 is Connor Kenyon. 58, Justin Tatura. That's Tatura's second sack. I kept giving penalties all the credit for bringing Eastside Catholic backwards, but that's not necessarily the case. Tatura's had some good sacks. 18 wide open across that middle. Seems to be the man they go to when they need a lot of yards. That's Hayden Meyer. That will now make it third and three at the 34 in Bainbridge territory again. Reynolds finds his man quickly. That's Hayden Meyer. Wrapped up, but gets the first down. Aaron Nordberg with the title or tackle. Meyer coming in today's game had 9 receptions for 118 yards and 2 touchdowns. Added quite a few yards to that this evening. Henry Jarvis in the backfield behind Reynolds now, number 40. And Chevy Walker has moved out to the right. As I look at it, as we Walker with it. Oh, there's another flag down. But nice tackle out on the outside. Nick Moore bringing him down on the outside. It might have been a chop block this time. We'll see what they see. Again, a hold. And again, I saw another flag on the sideline. Must have been just passing it along. So they're moving it for the hold. One of their best defenders this evening has been the yellow penalty flag. Looking at first and 20 on the 29. Bainbridge leading 17-16, 2:34 here in the third quarter that's remaining. Reynolds in at quarterback, brings his man in motion. Oh, Dietrich is chasing him, somebody else too! Josh Molskness with that sack. I think he's had a couple as well. He's a 6-foot senior, 185 pounds. Bainbridge trying a few more blitzes and getting some penetration there. Quarterback Trey Reynolds is listed at 6 foot, 185 pounds, but he's on the losing side of a couple of these battles lately. Reynolds sees, looking for a receiver, going deep. Oh, nice job by the defender. That's number 3, Lars Nelson, batting it down, almost coming up with the INT. Lars, also a senior. These class of 2012 playing nicely tonight. Third and a long 26 on the 35.
Third down and 26.
Secondary playing pretty deep right now. Chris Bell trying to set people up from his spot. He's kept the ball. That's Walker with the ball. Gains about 6, but that's not near enough for a first down. Gets him to the 30-yard line. Bainbridge playing tough D out there right now. More negative yards than positive at the moment. Fourth down, 21. Not surprisingly, Danny Omiliak coming in. I am sure this Bainbridge team has been schooled on what to do if they touch this kick this time. Trying for the block. And it certainly got the leg. And it is going to be good. So as we come near the end of this third quarter, it is now 19-17. Omiliak putting up six of those from field goals and one from an extra point. Bainbridge certainly has plenty of time to come on back. This is with 55.5 seconds. FG by Omiliak. And that will give them a 2-point lead, 19-17. And again, these two teams that are so evenly matched, coming in both 4-3 and 1-2 in league, are within 2 points of each other, tied 10-10 at halftime. And we've seen a couple touchdowns since then. We had a touchdown run by Jarvis at the 6-10 remaining in the third quarter, which made it 16-10, and they missed the extra point. But Bainbridge came right back at 4:29 in the third quarter. Belg went in with a 1-yard run, put them in the lead, 17-16, thanks to Connor Winship's extra point. And then the leg of Mr. Omiliak gives the Crusaders a 19-17 lead. Chris Bell is back deep, and Omiliak will once again put that leg in action. He's got it deep, but it's going to go out of bounds. And the Spartans let it go out, which was a smart move. They will bring it up to the 35, and that's where the Spartans will start. That went out at about the 10, so that's a nice gain of 25 right there. 55.5 seconds, nothing came off the clock, nobody touched the ball.
As a result, we keep going out of bounds, the Spartans will take over.
Bainbridge will come out here with a little time left in the third and a whole fourth quarter yet to try to make up this 2-point deficit. Senior Chris Bell behind center. Got a couple running backs back there with him. Hands it off to Fitch. Fitch brings it up to about the 40. Fitch was tackled by Brian Cox of the Crusaders. On the 40-yard line, we're looking at 2nd and 5. The ball people getting a workout tonight, hustling in and off as both these teams come into the line quite quickly. Bell still with the ball. He's going outside. Now he's found come inside. He's shrugging him, and he's out of bounds at about the 30. Trying to get the crowd to get excited, and boy, they are. Really nice run by Bell. Looked like they should have had him. He was in a sea of white, but he just kept going. 13.9 seconds. Making the best of this third quarter as they can. Bell right behind center. Two running backs behind him. Hands it off to the first man through. That is Weissong. Another Spartan first down. 7.3 seconds remaining. Stops long enough for them to reset the chains. Very possibly that might be our last play of this third quarter. And it certainly looks like that's what the Spartans are thinking. They're walking to the sideline to talk to Coach Grimm. And that's the same sideline that their fans are on and that they are cheering loudly for their seniors of class of 2012, as long as all those other underclassmen who are playing such a great game tonight. And that is the end of three quarters with the score 19-17, Crusaders in the lead. Starting the fourth quarter, it's 19-17, Crusaders in the lead, but here comes Chris Bell for another first down. Oh no, that's Matt Weissong, Max Weissong, sorry. 25, not number five. Spartans rolling right now. They have done this all on the ground. They just keep moving. Huge credit to that front line. They are making holes everywhere. Right side, left side, up the middle, around the end. And first and goal from the five. Weissong gets it first. He's going to go all the way. He's in! Not even letting a half a minute go off the clock at 11:34. The Spartans regain the lead. So we'll see if they, going for the extra point now, they have a 23-19 lead. Looking to extend that by one more. Bainbridge band playing the fight song. And I tell you, there are some legs on these kickers this evening. Winship took that, I think, over the fence almost outside of that. They have a track surrounding this field, and then there's a fence, and it did go over. Luckily, there are kids who are always willing to go after a ball. Fourth quarter starts out how the Spartans obviously like it, but there is a ton of time, a whole quarter left, to see what both teams are going to do yet. Not a lot of stoppage out there. A lot of scoring is what there's been. And right now, Bainbridge in the lead, 24-19. I'm Kitty Campagna on this mic, bringing this to you live up here at Bainbridge Island on a cool October 20th. Just at halftime, we heard that the World Series 2 is tied now, so this is just kind of a night of ties and closeness. Texas won 2-1, so that is going to... I guess it goes next to Texas. I believe it started in St. Louis. But right now, we are at Bainbridge Island. Bainbridge going to kick it off. That's Connor Winship who will be kicking off. Back to receive the kick, Chevy Walker. Chevy's been a busy man on... keeping it away from Walker, not a bad plan. But they're going to give it to him anyway. They do the pitch, and there's Walker. But there's some Spartans to meet him. Not a bad plan. Tough thing to execute on a kickoff. And a great job at staying home by the Spartan defense. Trey Reynolds still in as quarterback. He's the junior. Had a very successful year, 55 of 94 passing for 767, 67 rushes for 523, four touchdowns. And he's their punter, but we haven't seen that tonight. And he's their runner. Brought down by from behind by Nick Moore. Two-yard gain. It'll make it second and eight from the 27. And it looks like number seven's in there now. Luke Shepard at quarterback. He drops it. And he almost threw that to Lars Nelson. Looking at Hayden Meyer, but hit Nelson instead. And unfortunately, that went out of it, went through his hands. Third down, eight from the 27. Actually in their own territory to start this drive. Looking to see if they can actually force a punt this time. Another low snap. That was to Reynolds. Credit Callis with that. He meets up with Hayden Meyer as the ball gets there, knocks it down, and we're going to see an actual fourth down.
And fourth down and 8 yards to go from the 30.
Fourth and eight on the 27-yard line. And I do know that Trey Reynolds is their kicker. He is up there. And it's a sideline punt. Good pickup by the Bainbridge man back. That's Chris Bell. Chris Bell still going forward. He's got it across the 50. And he is in Crusader territory. As we said, how even these teams are, they even basically have the exact same logo. If you look at their websites, they're very, very similar. It is the Spartan helmet for one, and I assume it is the Crusader helmet for the other. Excellent job by Bell to get his team into Crusader territory. They will start out on the 48, first and 10, with a 24-19 lead. 10 minutes, 31 seconds remaining in the fourth quarter in this game. This league contest, Bell's just going to keep it now. Uh-oh, ball goes out of bounds. Fortunately, Bell pats himself and says, my bad, my bad. Luckily for him, that one goes out of bounds, and they're actually going to get it a first down on that. I was just going to say that I thought that they were putting the ball in the hands of Bell, who comes to the sideline, grabs a towel, wipes them off. He does not want that to happen again. You want sure hands out there right now. Bell up under center. Two backs behind him. This is Weissau. I believe that's Fitch. And he was met by 71 and 50. Jared Chatton, or Nick Sotelo, and Brian Cox. So that's going to make it second and 13. Bainbridge coming up to the line. Fitch and Weissong behind Bell. On the end, you get Lars Nelson. There are so many Crusaders in there long before the Spartans are able to block on that particular one. Keep losing yardage at this point.
Third down and 15 yards to go.
Loss of about three more, third and 15. Good size guys down there for Eastside Catholic. Big and fast. This is such a scrunched set that Bainbridge does. Kind of hard to even get the handoff off before people are in. Good block by 52. Bell finds 32. That's Fitch. Fitch runs along the sideline. It's a tightrope back. And he is at the 29-yard line. Not enough for a first down, but certainly more positive yardage than it looked like there for a minute. Good blindside block, otherwise Bell was going to be in huge trouble there. Fourth and three at the 29. Bainbridge going for it. Oh, and Bell is brought down. Markel Sanders, one of them, bringing him down.
Stopped by Zane Allen.
And that will become a Crusader ball. So with 8:57 remaining, Bainbridge will turn it over on downs. And the Crusaders will take it and see if they can go the length of the field. They trail by five, needing a touchdown to take the lead. First and 10 on the 33. Crowd trying to excite the Spartan team, yelling them on. Reynolds keeps the ball, eludes first man, and it is Chevy Walker. Chevy Walker coming down with it. That is going to be a Eastside Catholic first down. I want to make sure we give Annette Duval and the athletic secretary a thank you for helping arrange us coming up here, making sure we're doing just fine, getting us lineups, things like that. We try to have the right names, do our best on pronunciations. All thanks to the help we get from these athletic departments. There's Hayden Meyer. Nasty tackles right there. Nordberg, one of them, bringing them down. Looks like it's a darn close to a first down. Second and one from the 45, which is the Bainbridge 45. These sideline personnel have had to get their steps tonight moving up and down with these teams. See O'Milliak practicing field goal, but a field goal is not going to get them what they want, and Reynolds does get them what they want. He gets the first down. Henry Jarvis and Justin Totura met up in the backfield. Little tackle back there, kind of some extracurriculars going on. Pete Kimball coming this side, 24 coming this side, Luke Latanzio, Reynolds back. He's got Walker behind him. He's going to hand off to Walker. Just one block in front of him that frees him for another first down. Connor Kenyon has come really close to a couple, catching him in the backfield. And then just that burst of speed from Walker or Reynolds where he's not quite able to get to him. 7:33 here left in the fourth quarter. 24-19, Spartan lead. Crusaders threatening. First and 10 on the 31. Managing to stay away from the yellow hankies this particular drive. Walker's going to come on the outside, takes it back to the inside, has a good 6 yards, maybe seven.
Debbie Walker to the 25-yard line, gain of six.
Second and four on the 25. Sam Ory with the stop. Bainbridge kind of on their heels right now, these Crusaders moving so quickly. Hands off to Walker. And that time, he is stopped. Connor Kenyon bringing him down, 33, finding the angle that time. That Bainbridge defense looking a little bit tired right now. They've been out there quite a while. 6:24 remaining in the fourth quarter. Both these teams can run. Crusaders do add in the pass a little bit more often, but they've been just staying with Walker. Why not? Nordberg brings him down, but it's going to be another Crusader first down. First and 10 on the 18. Clock continues to run right down to about the 6 minute mark. New lineup, that's it. Something of a wildcat back to Reynolds, and he doesn't get a whole lot out of that. One of the first, they've run that set a couple times with him in the backfield, even with his running backs. whole team looks over to find the play. And again, a strange lineup. A couple guys, a couple yards behind along with the quarterback and the running back. Quarterback still has it. He's looking for his receiver. And is it caught? No, does not complete it. And that is Lars Nelson with the breakup. It was Springfield, I believe, trying to make the reception. Or it might have been Matt Callens. He was in the area as well. Third and nine on the 17. Really nice fake on that, a well-devised play, but the defense caught up with it. This time we're just going to do a straight pass. Finds his receiver, Callens. And that is a touchdown for Eastside Catholic. 5:11 left in this game, and Eastside takes the lead. 25-24. A pass from Reynolds to Callens. And looking to do the extra point now. They're thinking of going for two. Kicker is not out there, Danny Omiliak. Instead, they'll go for two on this. Reynolds still has it. Oh, they're tripping over each other. And he is upended, but goes into the end zone for two. That will give the Crusaders a three-point lead, 27-24. So they get the two-point conversion. Now the Bainbridge Spartans are going to come to the side and go back to the offensive end. Most of these guys who play defense also play offense. For instance, Chris Bell out there of the full time. He is just going to go back and now be a quarterback. Switch it off. 5:11 left to see who's going to be the number three seed of this particular Mountain, 3A Metro Mountain Division. At the moment, the Crusaders have a 27-24 lead. Bainbridge with plenty of time to bring this back and see if they can take the lead one more time. 3 points separate these two teams, so a field goal can tie, and we can get into those overtime things, just like the very first game of the year that Bainbridge won. They did an overtime against North Kitsap and won that 13-7. Bainbridge started this season four straight wins and then suddenly three straight losses. So they are ready to break that losing streak and see that W beside their name again. This is Eastside Catholic out of Sammamish, Washington that they're playing today. One of their league opponents in the Mountain Division. Eastside has done a win-lose sort of season. Uh-oh. And that one just flies. Oh, that has now gone to the end zone, and that is an official touchback. But that was quite the kick. Went off Bell's hands. Bainbridge will get the ball at the 20. They are going to have to take it the length of this field, your typical length. 80 yards for a score. 80 yards for the touchdown that would give them the lead. Possibly not nearly as far for their if they can go for that field goal, but that would meet overtime on this chilly evening up at Bainbridge Island. Chris Bell right behind center. Man in motion is Nordberg. Bell keeps it. He sees that inside lane. He's still running. Hit hard by number three at the end of that. Matt Callens, the gentleman who just had the touchdown for that Crusader team. So in the same way that the Bainbridge players play defense and offense, you're seeing that on Eastside Catholic with Callens. Quite often in your secondary, those will be guys that you're going to see on the offense as well. They are the athletes. 52 with it, going out for the lead block. Bell better hang on to that ball. He's got it out to the side. He's got the sideline. He's got a first down. They say he's out at the 47.
Gain of 19 yards, and the Spartans will have a first and 10.
19-yard gain, first and 10 for Bainbridge Island at their own 47. Nordberg's fixing his shoe in the backfield. He goes off to the left-hand side. Bell up to the line. Bill's got someone coming at the blind side. He's throwing it, but his receiver did not turn around. That was number 81.
Pass intended for Nick Beerley.
Nick Beerley. Thinking Beerley thought that was run all the way. That will stop the clock, and it will put it at second and 10 on their own 47 still. Spartans have been pretty consistent in getting positive yardage on all of their plays. Not overly successful in the passing game. Bell was 3 of 6 in that first half and one interception. Here comes Nordberg off the other side. Going to bring it to at least the 45. Not a first down, but a much more manageable third down.
Ball spotted at the Eastside pass at 46-yard line.
He went out at the 46. That's going to make it third and three. Nordberg comes across again. You got some Eastside Catholic guys coming hard and fast, but it looks like Bell's got the first down. Peter Kimball pulling himself up where Bell left him in the dust. Eastside Catholic continues with something of a sideline blitz where they're bringing him in from the other side and fortunately have not quite got the angle yet on Bell. 3:28 in this quarter and in this game. That's going to go off to Wyson.
Back Wyson, the ball carrier.
Gain of 6. Second and 4 from the 35.
Second down and 4 yards to go for the Spartan first down.
Both teams have gotten off to that line quickly. This is that hurry up offense. Exactly 3 minutes remaining in this game. Bell up to the line. Senior confidence. Nordberg takes off. Hands it off to Wysong again. Stopped.
Back Wysong for no gain.
And Chris Bell calls timeout. Or so I thought. I was wrong. Third down and 4. 2:34 remaining. Plenty of time. Number 5 coming in from this side. Bell trying to go forward. Not going to happen. Number 4. Elisha Paaga bringing him down, and Anthony Roy is the one coming from the side. Bainbridge calls a timeout. This is a do or die play. 2 minutes and 14 seconds remaining in this game. Fourth and 4 on their on the Crusader 35. Need at least a field goal to tie. That would be a 45 add 7 52-yard field goal. I don't think so. Or they need a first down to keep this game going. Do or die. The closeness of this game continues. These teams are so similar. Awesome field goal kickers on both teams. Tough quarterbacks. Some good running. Just continue to play hard out there. Bainbridge facing a very difficult situation, but they have proven earlier tonight that they can get that amount of yardage. We wonder what Andy Grimm is calling on the sideline. These guys are meeting. They get that minute timeout. Here we are, West Sound TV, bringing you another classic. And the Kitsap Sun streaming it live. fans exhorting their team. Tension in the stadium. They crowd that line, and they make the stop. The Crusaders have stopped them with 2:10 remaining in the game. Weissong not able to bring it forward. Those on the Crusader sideline, the guys in white jumping up and down, cheerleaders jumping up and down, maybe to keep warm. The fans are jumping, and that once again is for sure to keep warm, but they are a happy group over there right now. Bainbridge not out of it. I believe they still have 3 timeouts. They trail 27-24, having moved into Crusader territory. They're looking at trying to strip that ball now. It is Walker with the ball. He's gone on the outside. If they do this right, they can knock him out of bounds, and that will stop the clock. That does help. You know that coach is talking to him. What are you doing? Going out of bounds. Eastside Catholic proving that they can certainly get a lot of yardage more times than once tonight. Jeremy Thielbar is their coach.
Second down, 11 yards.
Second and 11 from the 34. Clock stopped at 2:04. Missed returning to the field. Low snap. Reynolds is looking for a receiver. That is caught. I would say it is short. Ooh, they've given him a little more than I thought that he had. I thought it was short of the first down. Timeout for a measurement. Oh, no, first down.
And that's enough for Eastside Catholic first down.
That's not going to help with it. That will, as soon as they set those chains, that will reset the clock. They'll be moving it again. Bainbridge has used up one of their timeouts. First and 10 from the 45 for the Crusaders. Not afraid to pass even in that situation. This is a team that's passed for over 1,000 yards. First half had 173 yards passing. Bainbridge fans saying, get the ball, get the ball. They might be able to just about kneel these things now. Big back with it now. He's just there to hold on to it as he goes through. That is number 4, Elijah Paaga, 5'9", 240-pound sophomore, running back, linebacker, fullback, refrigerator wannabe, I think. But he has had 9 runs this year for 109 yards, so he has been used this way before, but I get visions of William Perry right there. 1 minute and 19 seconds remain, 27-24. We are West Sound TV. I'm Kitty Campagna on this mic. Spencer Anderson, who's streaming, running the camera with his cold fingers. We crowd the good-sized crowd here on a Thursday night on Bainbridge Island. High school game of the week. And then we'll have a special game of the week tomorrow, Squim at North Kitsap for the Olympic League Championship. 1:19 remaining. I believe that Bainbridge, in fact, they do have them actually up there. That Bainbridge has one more timeout. It is 2nd and 7 on the Crusader 48. Low snap again. Walker keeps it. Does not get the first down, but he's up across that midfield line up to about the 47. Bainbridge is out of timeouts now. They've used the last one. Thinking they make these 30-second timeouts when they're used this way. Coach Grimm on the sideline in his shorts, brave soul that he is actually bringing his guys over to have a quick conversation. Now the officials are conferring, saying it's just a 30-second timeout, I think. Or now they're making it a full timeout. Eastside Catholic coming out ready to play. 1 minute, 13 seconds left in this contest to determine the number 3 seed. Eastside Catholic holding the advantage right now, 27-24 and the ball. 1:13 remaining, 3 timeouts left for Eastside Catholic, none for Bainbridge. 3rd and 2 at the 47. They get a first down. This game is basically over. Bainbridge got quite a few on that line. Low snap again. And we have a first down for Eastside Catholic. That would be number 4 again.
Ka'aga. The ball carry for Eastside Catholic.
The clock stops as they move the chains. That's going to be 107 in the game. As soon as they get it down, that clock starts moving again. 25-second clock in high school. The Crusaders, as typical, are right up to that line, but they can let another good 20 seconds off that clock, and they don't. They go down on a knee a little early, but they do have time for 2 more knees, I'm sure, which as they knee, suddenly the crowd stands, and many of them are getting ready to go warming again after seeing an extremely good game. Bainbridge played very well, had an opportunity, turned it over on downs with about 2 minutes left in this game. Definitely played extremely well. Neither defense was what you would call stellar. They got some plays when they needed it, but it's been a night of offense, even if the score is only 27-24. Second knee's taken. They aren't going to have to take anymore. And with 7 seconds going down to the double zero, Eastside Catholic is going to win this 27-24. I am Kitty Campagna on this mic for West Sound TV. I have Spencer Anderson on the camera streaming it as well. Thanks to the Kitsap Sun for helping us with the stream possibilities. We are having a great time bringing high school sports to you. We'd like to thank you for joining us this evening, being with us. And please, please come again when we continue to bring your community to you.